This was very significant. So he brought onto his team a guy called Alfred Lucas, who had some experience of crime scene investigation. In fact, he had got himself a reputation as Egypt's Sherlock Holmes. Lucas identified rather a lot of evidence that the tomb had been raided. Again, these photographs of Harry Burton's show very clearly the kind of evidence that Lucas was looking at. Some of the objects that were placed inside these chests were clearly intended to have been placed elsewhere, and probably were. Lucas also noticed that in one case in particular, there appeared to be some footprints on one of the chests. Perhaps there's evidence of the people going in there and disturbing this material.
Carter estimated that 60% of Tutankhamun's jewelry was stolen, likely by the very workmen who had been trusted to build and decorate the tomb. But the big ticket items, the gold coffins and the mask, were untouched. Yet this is unique in the Valley of the Kings. Every other royal tomb in the valley was stripped bare in a crime wave that swept Egypt 200 years after Tut's death. This is...
During the 20th dynasty, things really start to fall apart in Egypt. The king isn't nearly as powerful. And then here you have the workers who are operating in the Valley of the Kings, and they're not being paid. And so they have one of the first strikes that we know in history. As a result, they have to reach to other forms of revenue, which included going into the royal tombs in the King's Valley. And from this, we have a number of papyri which detail the robberies of royal tombs.
Remarkable documents tells of a murderous crime spree from those tumultuous times. They needed people who could help them launder the stolen goods.
If you had recognizable goods, essentially, you know, gold and jewelry that had come from a royal tomb, it was pretty obvious where it came from. So they had to have accomplices. They had to have officials who were higher up in the ranks in order to sort of launder the goods that they had robbed from the tombs.
In this crime wave, every royal tomb in the Valley of the Kings was stripped of its treasures, except for one.
What's remarkable?